press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students, welcome to the class, and I'm here to teach you the poem from your detail book, that is The Rebel. The Rebel is the poem from your detail textbook. So dear students, keep your textbook open so that when I read the lines, you'll be able to see your textbook. Before we go to the poem, let's have the introduction about the poet. The poet of the poem Rebel is D.J. Enright. The full name of this poet is Dennis Joseph Enright. He was a British poet, novelist and critic. So this person, D.J. Enright, he writes the poem. He has written many beautiful poems and many novels, and he was a critic. A critic, what is the meaning of critic? The critic means a person who judged the works of the art. A person who judged the works of art means the any author or any poet, if they are writing something. So before we approve their work, there will be the committee of the people who judge the work, and they remove some faults in that, and it has to be corrected by the people, by the person who has written that. And also they will praise the work also. So when it is approved, then only it is going to be published. So this critic is a person who judged the art. He is the person who judged the art, the way they write and the words what they use, and everything will be judged by the critic people, and they give their own opinion regarding their work. So a critic means a person who judged the works of art and find faults. So that is the meaning of critic. So D.J. Enright, Dennis Joseph Enright, was a British poet, novelist and critic. He was born 11th March 1920 in UK and died 31 December 2002 in UK. So this is the introduction about the poet. So now let's come to know what is the poem about. So dear students, what is the meaning of rebel? Rebel means a person who often violent or disagree with others' opinion. I repeat, rebel means a person who often violent and disagree with others' opinion. For example, when you are sitting in a group with the friends, and if someone says that I like the mango fruit, and the person say, no, I don't like mango, I like something pineapple or grapes. So the person who often disagree with others' opinion, they will not at all agree, and that they will never say that you are right. They will always say that I am right. They will never agree the opinion of others. They will be violent, they will be disagreeing, they will be disapproving others' opinion, and they will say that only I am right. So that person is called rebel. Some like stubborn nature people, they will be. They will be having their own ideas, and they want to do only what they want to do. They will never obey or accept or follow others' opinion. They will never take advice of anyone. They will do only what they feel correct, and they will say that only they are correct. They will not at all agree the advice or opinion or any views of any other people. So this is about the rebel. It's something different kind of nature persons, like stubborn people we say. So they think that they are right according to their views. They will never accept about others' opinion. So this is one kind of nature, one kind of human being will be having their different views, different ideas, and sometimes they will share their ideas, and sometimes they will ask advice of others, and sometimes they will ask to tell their opinion. But the rebel are the people, they never accept others' opinion or others' advice or suggestions. Never they are going to say that you are right. They will always say that I am right. So that kind of nature some people will be having. So here the rebel is the one kind of nature. In this poem, we can see that there is one boy. okay, and he is always disagreeing with other people. He never accept the opinion of others. So I'll read the poem for first four stanza. Just look at your textbook. Before that, there is one introduction part, dear students. Just look at it. Do you know anyone who always disagree with you and your friends, or likes to do opposite what everyone thinks they should do? Means what all group people are doing, they want to do something different, something opposite to that. So that nature the people will be. For example, in summer season, okay, everybody wants to eat ice cream or want to drink some cold drinks. They will prefer something cold during in summer season. But these rebel people, they will often go opposite to that. In the summer, they would like to have a hot cup of coffee or tea. See how? And during winter, everybody wants to have a cup of coffee, very hot coffee. But these rebel people, they will go to prefer the ice cream. So they will do totally opposite. What everybody do, they do something opposite, something change and different they will be. So that is one kind of nature. So okay, here just you see the paragraph. Do you know anyone who always disagree with you or your friends? So in a group of friends, there will be one person like rebel. They will never accept the opinion or suggestions of others. Or they do opposite whatever they should do. Think of a word to describe such a person. Discuss with your partner and give your opinion. So if you have come across with such people who often do opposite what others do, you can write a note about them. So now let's begin the poem. When everybody has a short hair, the rebel lets his hair grow long. When everybody has long hair, the rebel cuts his hair short. When everybody talks during the class, the rebel doesn't say a word. When nobody talks during the class, the rebel creates a disturbance. See, you can see in these lines, the rebel is doing totally opposite. When everybody has short hairs, so there is just one trend that everybody wants to cut their hairs in the shapes and everybody are having short hairs. But rebel wants to grow his hair long. When everybody has long hairs, the rebel cuts his hair short. See, totally opposite he wants to do. He don't want to go with the group. He want to be alone, separate and different. He doesn't want to go with the how the group is going. He don't want to follow them. He want to be separate and want to do something unique and different. So once again, see that when everybody has short hairs, the rebel lets his hair grow long. When everybody has long hairs, the rebel cuts his hair short. When everybody talks during the class, so in the class, when everybody are talking before the teacher enter the class, all students will be talking like you people. Right? So all are talking there in the class, there is a lot of disturbance. In that moment, rebel will shut his mouth and he will sit quiet. When everybody is shouting in the class, he will be sitting very quiet. When everybody talks during the lesson, so when the teachers are teaching the lesson and when teacher asks any question to discuss, when everybody will be sharing their own opinion, by that time he will be keep his mouth shut. He will not open his mouth, he will not speak. When everybody talks during the lesson, the rebel doesn't say a word. When nobody talks during the lesson, when the teacher is explaining something and all students are listening it carefully, by that time the rebel creates a disturbance. He will do something or other to divert the mind of teachers and he will create some disturbance. See how total opposite. When everybody wears a uniform, the rebel dresses in fantastic clothes. When everybody are coming, so there will be the particular day. See, special is from Saturday. Okay, Saturday you are supposed to wear white uniform. Okay, that is compulsory for everyone. But rebel will wear color dress. He will do a total opposite. When all people are doing the same thing, he will do something opposite. See, when everybody wears uniform, the rebel dress in fantastic clothes. When everybody wear fantastic clothes, the rebel dresses soberly. So what it means? When everybody wears fantastic clothes, so there will be some functions. Say something, celebration is there in the school, just like Teacher's Day, Children's Day, or any your annual day, this will be there. No? Then one particular day will be given to the students to wear what they like, the color dress they can wear. Okay? But during such days, the rebel, he wears sober dress. Sober means dull. Write down the meaning, dull. He will wear very dull dress. When everybody are with colorful, bright and grand dresses, he will wear dull dress. And when everybody wears uniform, he will wear very grand dress and he will come. So like that. When everybody wear fantastic clothes, the rebel dresses soberly. In the company of dog lovers, the rebel expresses a preference for cats. When everybody says that we like to have a dog as a pet. In the dogs, there will be many varieties. Many quality will be there. Doberman will be there. And many other, you know the better than me regarding the quality of dogs, many other, Pomeranian dog will be there, many other. And in such, while students, when the boys in a group or students in a group, they discuss that we would like to have a dog as a pet. During that discussion, the rebel says, the rebel expresses the preference for cat. He says, no, dog is not good, I would like to have a cat as a pet. So he wants to tell something opposite. He will never follow the group. He wants to be something unique. In the company of cat lovers, the rebel puts a good word for dogs. So when all were talking about dogs, he was talking about cat. When everybody starts speaking about cats, he will go for dog preference. See, like that. In the company of the cat lovers, the rebel puts a good word for the dog. So before he, when everybody was speaking about dog, he did not like good dogs. He want to have a cat as a pet. When everybody says, yeah, yes, cat also is very good, so let's have a cat as a pet. Then he will say, no, I don't want the cat, I will go for the dog. So like that, he wants to do something opposite to what other people are doing. In the company of cat lovers, the rebel puts a good word for dogs. Okay, so this is the first part of this poem. So once again, I will read the poem. Just look at it. When everybody has a short hair, the rebel lets his hair grow long. When everybody has long hairs, the rebel cuts his hair short. When everybody talks during the lesson, the rebel doesn't say a word. When nobody talks during the lesson, the rebel creates a disturbance. When everybody wears a uniform, the rebel dresses in fantastic clothes. When everybody wears fantastic clothes, the rebel dresses soberly. In the company of dog lovers, the rebel expresses a preference for cat. In the company of cat lovers, the rebel puts a good word for dogs. So in the first part you saw that the rebel is doing totally opposite what other people are doing. When the group of people are agree and they support for any opinion, he will be saying something opposite for that. He don't want to join the group. He will be something separate and he want to do totally different what other people are doing. So now let's come to know to the second part. When everybody is praising the sun, the rebel remarks on the need for rain. When people say, wow, it is a pleasant morning, how beautiful sunshine, it's so nice to go outside and have picnic and outdoor games. When people are greeting the sun, he will remark for the rain. Oh, it is not that the sunshine is very hot, we are feeling very hot, sweating. So it was better if we had a rain. So opposite. When everybody is greeting the rain, when everybody likes to, go outside when it is raining or make some paper boards and play, he will regret for the absence of sun. See, when everybody is greeting the rain, the rebel regrets the absence of sun. During that time, he will say, what it is raining from morning to evening, we are not so able to go out, we are not able to play outdoor games. It was better if we had sunshine today. Like that, when it was sunshine, he was speaking about rain. When it is raining, he wants the sun. Everything he want to do opposite with the what other like. When the group of people say something, he want to do opposite to that. He don't want to follow or he don't want to support the opinion of others. He will speak totally opposite for that. When everybody is praising the sun, the rebel remarks on the greed for rain. When everybody is greeting the rain, the rebel regrets the absence of sun. When everybody goes to the meeting, the rebel stays at home and reads a book. When there will be the meeting and one particular date and time will be given to the people to come and attend the meeting. When everybody are going for the meeting, he will not go. He will sit at home and he will read the books. See, when everybody goes to the meeting, the rebel stays at home and read a book. When everybody stays home and read the book, the rebel goes to the meeting. He alone wants to go to the meeting. When everybody, when in a group, when people are sitting for the meeting, he will not attend that one. When everybody at home, they are having their leisure time, he will go for the meeting. When everybody says, yes, please, the rebel say, no, thank you. So when people offer something, especially during the party time, we can say, when people offer you some eatable things, snacks, this, that, they will bring some tray and they will offer you, have some piece of cake or take some biscuits. Rebel say, no, thank you, don't want. When everybody say, yes, please, when everybody wants to take and have it, then rebel will deny that one. He don't want, no, thank you. When everybody say, no, thank you, the rebel say, yes, please. When everybody say, no, no, we don't want this, it's enough. Then that he would like to prefer, he want to take that one. He will say, yes, please. When everybody say, yes, please, the rebel say, no, thank you. When everybody say, no, thank you, the rebel say, yes, please. It is very good we have rebels. So, see, we should have our own choice. It is, sometimes is it, it is okay to go in a group. What the majority people agree, we have to agree the same. Because something valuable thinking will be there in that and people will agree for that and we have to support the majority. But sometimes when people are in majority and we feel that that is not correct, if we are standing alone also no problem, we have to fight for that. Alone also we have to fight for that. When we don't agree, when our soul and our heart doesn't agree that point of view, we have to wail in that one. Maybe we are alone, we have to speak up for that. So it says that it is very good that we are have rebels. We should have something unique thinking. We should not go as a group going, we have to follow that one. Sometimes it is okay, but you should have your own opinion. You should have your own thinking. No, never mind if no people are standing with you. If you have to fight alone, you have to fight alone. If there is no one with you, then also you have to fight alone if you feel that is wrong. If it is that is correct, you have to follow the majority. So sometimes rebels are good. So it says that it is very good that we have rebels. So something different thinking may come. Sometimes unique idea may get. So what other people are speaking, if we speak the same, we are common. They too are saying the same thing, these people are also saying same thing, it's common. But if someone is speaking something different, something unique, that person will be identified. And that sometimes that opinions and views, some fresh ideas may come from the mind of a rebel. So that only, they will be having the nature of thinking something different. So it is good to have the rebels. Then see the next line. You may not find it very good to be one. In the same time, being a rebel also is not good. Why it is not good? Because you will not have any friends. See, the friendship will be there when all people support each other. When all the members agree and support each other, and they feel the happiness may be, the sorrow may be, and they are adjusted with each other. But the rebel will not get adjusted, not get mingled with anyone. They want to be alone somewhere. They want to be something unique. They don't want to follow the group. Whatever the group will say, they will say, no, it's not right. No, it's not right. No, I don't want. When everybody say, no, I don't want, he will say, yes, I want. Like that. So such nature many people don't like. They always stay alone. They won't mingle with anyone. They won't get adjusted with the group people. They won't follow what others are doing. So such people face difficulty to be in a group of people. They want to stay somewhere alone and silent. And when they want to speak, the people, they don't like them to speak because they will speak everything opposite. If you say you are good, they will say, no, you are not good. If you say you are not good, he will say, yes, you are good. So they will speak something opposite only. So such people, they face difficulty to stay in a group. They won't get mingled with anyone. They will be somewhere separate, alone. And that is difficult for the person to stay alone. If you want to be in a group, first you need to adjust. You need to mingle with everyone. And you need to accept the other's opinion and their advice and their suggestions. You have to accept that one. You have to say, yes, what you are saying is right, I will follow. I will think of it. You have to accept. If you don't accept, you are out of the group. So when friends, if they say that, yeah, today let's go for the cricket. And you say, no, I will stay at home. Will they call you for the next time? No. And when they want to sit at home and have some rest time, and if you say, come, let's go for the cricket, they won't come. Because you did not go when they call you. So they will not come when you call them. Right? So such people, you know, they will face difficulty. And sometimes it is good also to be the rebel. That they will have their own unique ideas. They will have their own style of living. They will have their own style of thinking. And many people don't like it. Many people, they want, when we are having the majority of the group saying yes, we have to say yes. If it is wrong, then you have to stand alone and fight for that. Though everybody are saying yes, if it is wrong, you alone you have to fight, no problem. But if it is correct, you should not speak opposite to that. You have to accept that one, right? See, I told you one example that during summer season, all would like to have ice cream. And that time you say, hey, I hate ice cream, I want coffee. They will not accept with the group of people will not accept you. They will say, it's a summer season, you should have something cold. And during winter, if you offer everyone to have a ice cream, will they come with you? No, they will go for a coffee. So like that. You have to mingle and adjust when you are in a group. And if it is wrong and everybody are not ready to support you, it is wrong, you alone should stand and fight for that. So sometimes rebels are good and sometimes it is not good, because the person who is a rebel, he will face difficulty to stay in a group, because that person will not accept the views and opinions of others. So that is the difference. That is a little bit difficult to be a rebel, because many of the time he need to stay alone, because the group will not accept him, because he will be always speaking opposite, no? So many people don't like him to keep him in a group, because he will be saying something opposite to that. He will do totally opposite what others are doing. It may hurt some people. And rebels, it is good also when they are thinking something different, something unique, and they are not following the crowd. See, if there is one road and all people are going to that road, we will also go to that road. Means we should have our own destination. Where we have to go, we have to go on that road only. We should not follow the crowd. Yes. So following the crowd is different and making their own destination is different. So everybody are going to the left way. We want to go this road because majority people are going there. No, you should think where you have to go. If you have to go in the opposite direction, better to walk alone, but you have to reach your destination. No use of following the crowd. Okay? So like that, if the rebels are good for some time, for some particular situation, it is good. But majority, but the main, you know, in the whole day, we need some or other people to be with us. When we are outside, we need the people who work with us or the friends we need. When we are in the home, we need our family members. And if you don't support and if you don't accept the opinion of others, people will not like you. And you have to be alone in a group also, you have to be alone, you have to stand alone. Being in a group also, you will feel as if you are lonely. So this is the problem faced by a rebel. So the both positive negative points are here in this poem. So we have to act according to the situation. When the situation is like that, that majority people are saying yes, and also it is correct, you have to follow the majority. And when people say it is right and you feel that it is not right, you can stand for that. Okay? So we have to act according to the situations. We should have some unique ideas, plus we should have the nature of getting mingled with everyone, to getting adjust with everyone, to respect the opinion and advice and suggestions of others. Though they are telling something bad about you, we have to listen, because we have to respect their opinion. When you are asking someone to tell your opinion, they may say something bad which may hurt to you, but you should have that much firm your heart that if people are speaking wrong about you, you should accept that one, because that is their view, right? So like that, you should be having the nature to get adjust and mingle with everyone. So according to the situation, you need to act. So this is the actual message what the Dennis Joseph Indright wants to give you. So being a rebel is good for some time, but in the same meantime, it is something difficult also to lead the life alone. So here the second stanza, once again I will read. When everybody is praising the sun, the rebel remarks on the need for rain. When everybody is greeting the rain, the rebel regrets the absence of sun. When everybody goes to the meeting, the rebel stays at home and read a book. When everybody stays at home and read the book, rebel goes to the meeting. When everybody say yes please, the rebel say no thank you. When everybody say no thank you, the rebel say yes please. It is very good that we have rebels. You may not find it is very good to be one. So it is good to be a rebel, but it is not good to stay alone and lead a lonely life. Because when you want a group of people, you have to accept the different kind of thinking, opinion, suggestion, advice, everything you have to accept. If you say that only I am right and everybody are wrong, you can't lead a life alone. So this is the message given by the DJ Indright. So hope you understood the poem. Read the poem once again. There are many rhyming words are more in this. So it's beautiful poem and very easy to understand also. So I'll read the whole poem once again. So go to it. When everybody has a short hair, the rebel lets his hair grow long. When everybody has a long hair, the rebels cut his hair short. When everybody talks during the lesson, the rebel doesn't say a word. When nobody talks during the lesson, the rebel creates a disturbance. When everybody wears a uniform, the rebel dresses in fantastic clothes. When everybody wears fantastic clothes, the rebel dresses sober. Sober means dull. In the company of dog lovers, the rebel expresses a preference for cat. In the company of cat lovers, the ribbon puts a good word for dogs. When everybody is praising the sun, the ribbon remarks on the need for rain. When everybody greets the rain, the ribbon regrets for the absence of sun. When everybody goes to the meeting, the ribbon stays at home and read a book. When everybody stays at home and read the book, ribbon goes to the meeting. When everybody say yes please, the ribbon say no thank you. When everybody say no thank you, the ribbon say yes please. It's very good that we have ribbons. You may not find it very good to be one, means to be alone. So it's a beautiful poem written by D.J. Enright. So if you find any difficult words in this, you just underline, okay? And if you find any difficulty regarding the summary and explanation, you can drop the message, we'll clarify your doubts, okay? So once again, I will repeat the introduction about the poet, that is D.J. Enright. Dennis Joseph Enright was a British poet, novelist and critic. Critic means, I told you the meaning, a person who judges the works of art and find faults, okay? Then he was born 11th March 1920 in UK and died 31 December 2000 in UK. The meaning ribbon. The ribbon meaning means a person who often violent or disagree with the opinion of others. With others' opinion, okay, with the opinion of others or with others' opinions, one and the same. A person who often violent or disagree with others' opinion, okay. And sobri, sobri meaning means dull, very dull, means very light dress, very dull dress, it is not bright, like that, okay. Hope you understood the poem and go through with the poem once again. Read it carefully, underline the difficult words. If you find any difficulty, any, if you don't understand the explanation and all, you can drop the message, we'll clarify your doubts. Till then, take care, bye-bye.